Hello and welcome to my new office tour. We recently did a big move to California at the end of 2022, and it is almost 3.5 months later, and I finally feel like I'm not as burnt out and getting things in order. Also, I'll give you a little preview. Out here in the hallway, I have a bunch of my other squish squad. People always come over and they're like, oh, do you have kids? And I'm like, no, this is just my squishmallows. So this is Bella. Hi, sweetie. She's a little jealous that we're not paying full attention to her. She wants leggies, which is like where she's in my lap. She wants that 24/7, but Bella, I got to do this first, okay? She's not having it. Can I get past you? She's like, I'm going to ruin your video. So I'll do a quick pan, and then I was thinking it'd be fun to just go through some of this stuff. I'm not going to obviously show you everything. That would be a forever video. As you can see, there's a lot of things in here. But this is the gist of my room. So we'll start over here. I do have some stuff in here. I don't want to go too deep in here, but there is like another shelf and some other stuff here. Some more bags and some more boxes, and then just same kind of thing there. I do have another Alex shelf in here, a tall one. These tubs are like, I have Christmas decor in there, like pink mist basically, and some summer stuff. There's like a lot of cooler type bags and things like that that I'll use when I do planner picnics this summer. And then this still needs to be organized, but these labels are pretty much true for what's in here. I have like my laminators in here, painting and sewing projects, and then a lot of these boxes have like puzzles. That's my silhouette that I want to get into. You can see a little pink mist stuff up there, but that's basically all this is. And then sewing machine that my mom gave me. I really do want to get back into sewing someday. I want to learn how to quilt. That's like a future project. And I'm not a big fan of these three doors. I never feel like I get them the way I want them. This is one of my favorite squishmallows. I call him Big Boy Ronnie, but he's been moved around a lot. Maybe we fluff him up because his head's a little droopy. Oh, there, that actually helped. One thing I noticed is if you put, yeah, see, his head's still a little gooey, but if you put squishmallows in those airtight vacuum bags, I don't feel like they come back the same. So he was put in one of those and they get really wrinkly, and you can fluff them up in the dryer, but I feel like the dryer does something to the stuffing in them, because ever since then he's just been kind of like gooey. Whereas for instance, these other ones that weren't, they just have like a little more spring to them. Anyway, and then here is my exercise bike that I don't use as often as I would like, but I got this during the pandemic and it was really nice to just have something to do, you know, when we were all stuck inside, and I really like it. If I'm using it, sometimes I'll just get on here, like if I'm waiting to get on a Zoom call or if I want to watch a show or if I'm boxing a friend or something, I'll get on here. This is a purse that I'm currently going to move into for spring. I like to switch stuff up every now and then. I have so many purses, and so that's kind of fun. I don't think I'm going to get into that tower. There are some mugs in there. I guess I could show you some of the mugs. Some of the mugs. A lot of like Radon pink mugs. I feel like the Radon phase is coming to an end. And then here, I'm going to give you a overview here of this. And we'll kind of just go through everything one by one. So these are some of my strawberry purses. This has a cherry keychain. This down here, I have a book that has some reading notes I'm far behind on. This was kind of like my first, kind of one of my first bullet journals. I used this when I was in school. It's actually really cute. And this is how I used to track all of my homework. So as you can see, I would do half of a box if I was like in progress. Maybe I'll do a video where I walk through this, but I keep that. This was a book I got from Walmart. I feel like in 2014 or something. Gosh, time goes by so fast. And then in here, I have a little holder with all of my tarot and oracle cards. I had a little stint, I'd say in mid-2000s, 2014, 15, where I got really into some like woo stuff. And then it got kind of like, I don't know if you guys have ever experienced this. I'm just going to go on a journey with this video, by the way. You can fast forward or mute me if you don't care, but I kind of went on this little spiritual journey and really had my head in the clouds. And I also was talking to a lot of other people that were into that stuff too. And honestly, when I look back, it gives me the ick because I bought into a lot of stuff, like magical thinking. Like I remember at one point really thinking that the reason why I wasn't making more money in my business was because I wasn't thinking all the right thoughts. It just got really toxic. And looking back now, I'm like thinking about that. And, you know, I started listening to the Conspirituality podcast, which is so good. And just learning more about that whole dynamic and how it can be really problematic and how it can kind of turn into either an alt-right pipeline or just kind of some like cult kind of stuff. If you know what I'm talking about, you know what I'm talking about. I can elaborate it on another time. But anyway, so I just kind of like lost a lot of, like it left a bad taste in my mouth. And so I didn't get rid of a lot of these, but for a while, like these kind of just reminded me of that period in my life where I felt very like head in the clouds, you know, and kind of came back down to earth. My mom was actually like someone that really helped me through that. She was like, I went through a period like that too. Like, here's why, you know, we should stay rooted in reality. And I found that helpful. But anywho, I kept these because now I just kind of like to use these. This is one of my favorite ones. I just like to use them as kind of like journal prompts. So I find them really fun. So that's how I use them. I have a lot of really cool ones. Some of them are more just for fun. There's like a moonology one. There's tarot ones. Most of them are like oracle cards. Like you just kind of pull something and it gives you some info. So those are what those are. And then I have some excess greeting cards here. I always buy greeting cards from dollar stores. So these are all like two for a dollar. Even with the price increase where everything's like $1.25 now, these are still two for a dollar. So what I'll do is I'll go every quarter or so and I'll buy probably about like 20 cards. Sometimes I buy them because I really love like the artwork and I'll like cut stuff out and use it in my journals. But most of the time I just buy them because I want to send them to family or friends, or I like want to have, you know, cards on hand for special occasions. And I'm someone that loves snail mail and handwritten stuff. So I'm always sending people. If you give me your address, I'm going to probably send you a card. These are my strawberry squish mallows. I actually bought some of these like off Mercari and stuff because I wanted like all of them. I have another giant strawberry under my desk, but I just love these. I think they're really cute. And I had them like so you could see all of them at one point, but I'll have to fix that. So there are those. And then down here, I have some other mugs because this is like, I have my coffee bar up top. And I bought most of these at TJ Maxx or Marshall's around, you know, right before or during Valentine's Day, as you can tell, because I love these pink colors. These are little boxes I got. Most of the stuff I own is from TJ Maxx or Marshall's. So if I don't give you another place I got them, that's probably where they're from. These are Martha Stewart boxes. I really like her stuff, her brand. I find everything's really high quality. I really, really like it. But you can find this kind of stuff at like Staples, but it's like way, way overpriced. So if you can find it elsewhere, that's what I would do. But this top one has some stuff from Daiso, which is like a Japanese dollar store in the area. And I haven't even went through all that yet. Just like stickers and stuff. And then down here, this one, I should probably label these, has some more recent cards and stuff from like family members and my husband that I just really loved and want to keep. I don't keep all the cards I get from everyone ever, but I would have so many, but I do keep ones that are extra special to me. Some more purses here. I really love this bag. It reminds me a lot of Animal Crossing with all the little little veggies and butterflies and stuff. And then these are a bunch of my Happy Planner stickers and sticker books. As you can see, there's a lot of them. I've been collecting these for like 7 or 8 years probably, and I'm now just really starting to actually use them. But these can be quite expensive. I got most of these at Michael's, and I've always gotten them when they had like coupons or sales. So I never pay full price for them, but it's been a collection, and there's a lot of them, and these things are heavy. But these, they do sell, the Happy Planner website does sell holders for these, but I find they're kind of expensive and they're cardboard and they just don't seem that durable. These are actually little bins I got. They're plastic from Target. I'm sure they still have them. And I think, I want to say these were like anywhere between $2 and $4 each, but they're really sturdy. Like I can lift this whole thing up. I know it's not going to break, and they fit these perfectly, and they definitely hold way more stickers than some of the other holders that you can buy. So here's another one. This is like some of my pastel sticker books. And then this is an acrylic thing. I have another one of these in the bathroom that I put my face masks in. I love to take a bath almost every night and do a face mask. And it feels so luxury. So, but these are more of my greeting cards. Down here I have jumbo sticker books, some traveler's journals. I think this is an old Hobonichi Weeks. And some of these journals, I think these are from Walmart, actually. These are actually really nice. Hold on. Yeah. Pen and Gear. Pen and Gear is actually a really great brand. So these are just 192 pages. I can't remember if this one has, I don't think I've done anything, but these are like grid pages. I don't think. And then is this one also Pen and Gear? This one's so pretty. Oh no, this one is from, I think this one might be from Hobby Lobby. I don't go to Hobby Lobby really anymore, but I did a couple times. Every now and then I'll go in there and then I'm like, eh, I don't really want to go there. But I really like these. Oh, this one has stickers. Oh, and this one's lined. Okay, but anyway, really like those. I'm going to put these over here so we don't have to put them away during this video. But then we can come back up here. This house we're living in was actually built, we're in military housing, and was actually built, oh my gosh, in the 50s. I'm trying to figure out, I want to find out what year, but I've noticed that all the rooms only have outlets like on one side of the room. So until I get a drop cord, this is not plugged in. But eventually I will have this plugged in, and this is my little coffee maker. Keurig doesn't make the best coffee, I'll be honest, but I love the pink one. I think it's really cute. This is a little mug that I got. I love Winnie the Pooh. This is from Disney Japan. I ordered it from a store, and it actually got lost in the mail a couple years ago, and I was like, oh, I'm never gonna get it, and then it showed up 3 months later. This is a little pink teapot. I don't know what you call this, but it's the kind that has the mug underneath. I just think that's really cute. And then this, I just keep water in this for the Keurig. Another cute teapot I got off Amazon. If you search pink teapot, I'm sure it'll come up. I think this was like 20 bucks. This is a little handbook. I just thought this was so cute. I got this at Five Below. I think it was literally $5. I just thought it was cute. These are my birds from Target. I love them. It'd be really easy to buy a bunch of these, but I've been trying not to buy more.
more stuff anymore. I had kind of a shopping problem during the pandemic, which is how I acquired a lot of Squishmallows. But they have their little year down here in their name. And I just think they're really, really sweet. And every, seems like every holiday and season they come out with new ones. And then, I'll stand up here. My little cinnamon roll ones. These are fake flowers. These acrylic shelves I got off Amazon. I'll link to my Amazon storefront. I have most of this stuff kind of organized and linked there. And some tumblers. No plants in my house are real. These are all fake. And then we still have moving stickers. Oh gosh, everywhere. I keep finding them. This is, back from August of last year, I did a whole podcast episode on monthly mini goals. You can actually get this printable from my site. I can link it below. But I had like different goals, kind of like goals and intentions for August. These are actually really great. So I'd like to come back to these. I'm actually surprised that stayed on there. Like the movers didn't rip that off. Over here, this is kind of a little pile of stuff. This is actually a really cool book. It's Adventure Time. It's a bunch of posters. I actually would really love to have those up sometime. And then this is kind of like junk that needs to be organized. Down here, I have, these are more greeting cards. A lot of these are from the Target Dollar Spot. And that box, I have a couple boxes of stuff. This box is like those punch cutout things. I think they're from Martha Stewart, where you can like punch a heart or a tree or whatever. And then more washi tapes in there. These are some purses that I really love, but I have not used yet. Here's a paperback copy of my Daily Productivity and Brain Dump book. I have this available paperback or hardcover or digital. This I got at Five Below. I need to drink it, but I honestly just bought it because I thought it was so cute. It reminds me of, like, we still have, I don't know if you grew up, like, or your grandma or someone has them, but my mom still has, like, glass Coca-Cola Christmas bottles from, like, I don't even know when. And she still gets them out every year. Like, they're just, I don't know why. They're just still, they're still coking them, but we never drink them. This is one of my favorite things. I never would drink out of this. It's really just beautiful and for show. But I got this from Viva La Crafted. She makes these. She has a small business. And it felt like buying a piece of jewelry. But I love it. I look at it every day. People do drink out of them. I'm just like, it's too pretty. We're not going to do that. Then we'll get into my collection of planners. Again, anything that you want to see more in depth or detail, I could do other videos on, but these are a bunch of my planner covers from over the years. This is like a recollections one. I am so sad more and more that Michaels, Joanne, all those places really aren't carrying planners or stickers anymore. I mean, they must not have been selling enough of them, but I remember a time when you could go in and there'd be like two or three aisles devoted to planners and inserts and stickers. And it was heaven. It was just so fun to go in there, and you can bring your dog. So I would bring Bella and we would just spend an hour looking at stuff, and she'd get pets and get tired. And it was just the best. So up here I have some more stuff. I'm really obsessed with these like fuzzy purses lately. Like they get, I'm so scared to use this because I feel like it would get dirty so easily, but I just love it. A lot of these ones are actually Kiki K from, I actually got these in Michaels. They're so cute. This one's actually from Kiki K. I ordered it from Australia before they even had a US store back in like 2014, I feel like. I just remember paying a lot of shipping to get this. And so these are all like inserts. A lot of these are Aura Stell. Some of these are Kiki K. And they're all different sizes. So if you want to see a video on like all of those and a review, I can do that. And then I have these beautiful, beautiful boxes that actually don't have anything in them, but I just think they're so cute. I could probably save a lot of room by putting stuff in there. And then this one year, 1 year, a couple years ago, around Christmas time, I went to Marshall's and they have had all these makeup palettes that I just, oh, they're all different, like different flavors of chocolate and stuff. And they also had these little ones. And I'm just obsessed with, like, I'm just obsessed with them. And they were like relatively inexpensive. Like these ones were like $4. Anyway, so like for months I would go back like every Friday and see if they had new ones. And I ended up with all these. And I do use some of them, but I just am obsessed with them. It's just like this weird thing that I have. And then these are from when I was little. I don't think this is the complete set. I think I lost some of them, but so cute. And then I saved this Hobonichi box because it just matches with my pink. And some little flowers. This is one of my favorite teapots. I found this at Goodwill. Like, it's just stunning. And it's, I can't lift it up. I don't want to risk breaking it, but it is, oh my gosh, I can't remember the name. The Deft Blue, I think, is what, if you Google it, you can find more of their stuff. But it's just like, oh, it's so timeless and beautiful. And then in here, these are more of those Martha Stewart things. I actually have some student journals and planners in here that I've either bought or students have sent me, I think. Oh, and I also, these are actually, I also have some Japanese workbooks in here because last year for Christmas, I was like, I want to learn Japanese. And my husband bought me a bunch of stuff and I've still yet to do that, but it is still one of my goals. Because someday I want to go to Japan and see all the stationery stores and, oh my goodness. Here's another Squishmallow. This is one of the ones that's like furry. And this I got from Daiso. These are my little, these are from Devoom. They're like little computer things, but they're actually just like a Bluetooth speaker, but they're really cute. I love these like Juicy Couture bags. They're super, super darling. And then in here I have some of my favorite things. This is from this shop called Enormous Happiness, and she makes these resin keychains, and they're always really hard. She sells out of them. They're definitely like pieces of jewelry. I think some of these were like, I don't know, like I want to say $12 to $18, which is ridiculous. But I decided to buy a couple of them for myself, and I just am obsessed with them. I don't know, I just get them out and look at them and I think they're really lovely. And then I have a tower here. I wasn't gonna go as in depth with everything, but if you're still watching, we're gonna keep going. This is I got this bag from Marshall's. It's like iridescent. And there's some like, there's a diamond painting in there that I ordered offline when they first came out and I haven't started it yet. Now you can find them at craft stores everywhere. But this is, I have some like Sterling ink stickers and stuff in there. I love her stuff. It's beautiful. And then this is a pad of like papers. And this I'll have to show you another time. This is actually, my mom found this case for this in elementary school. In art class, we did like a pottery. They had like a kiln and we did pottery and stuff. And I actually, there was extra. And I begged my art teacher to let me do it. And I made like my own board game out of clay. And there's like little clay pieces. I can't remember the whole thing, but like I painted it. I made up a whole board game. And she was like, well, we don't really do that. And I was like, let me do it, please. And so I'm really proud of that. And then this in here is like little Bath & Body Works. I'm probably going to get rid of these, sell them on Mercari or something. But little sanitizer holders for my purse, like other purse-like things. These are inserts for mini, tiny pocket planners. This is Unravel Your Year. If you don't subscribe to Susanna Conway or get this free printable from her every year, it's so worth it. And then just some other stuff down here. And then here's my Alex drawers. I think I'm kind of getting tired, so I think I might do another video where I go through all of these. I did do photos on my Instagram. If you go at Sarah Steckler and to my highlights and go to the office tour, there is photos, and I show you that. Some paint by number kits. I got these from Target, Dollar Spot. They're so cute. They remind me of, there's this woman on TikTok. I think she lives in Australia. And she rescues all these animals and she lives by this little lake. And every day, every morning, she walks with her ducks down to the lake and then gets them in the afternoon and they walk up. And I think it's the most heavenly, beautiful thing ever. And so these reminded me of that. This is a little doll. I don't even know. I bought this from someone on Instagram. She just like on a whim was like, I want to try making dolls. And she made these and then she stopped. But I think this is like a, I think I bought this for like $20 shipped. But this is like a little flower. And then I don't even know how she did this. I think it's wire and twine. I just thought this was like so magical. Like, and it's like a little garden fairy. So she is just totally hanging out there. These are some pens from Angel Shop. This is from Temu. There's, you can order like stickers and stuff from online. And then I love these mats. They're really great, especially if I'm doing like paint by number and I get something on it. It's just really easy to clean instead of my desk. This is a standing desk, so it'll actually go up, which is why there's nothing on the wall here and this why this is so high. So when I raise this, I could do that. This guy stole my heart. I had to have him. Like, so cute. Oh my goodness, I love it. And then here's my desk. So another Target Dollar Spot find, some other stuff. I actually found this. I think I've had that forever. I can't remember. I think I got it from the Goodwill, but I can't remember when. Those flowers are from IKEA. And then I'm gonna come over here and sit down. Got my diet caffeine-free Coke, which I'm kind of obsessed with lately. I spent my whole life not allowing myself to have any like diet products because when in the 90s my mom was like, aspartame's gonna kill you, and then I finally was like, I wanna drink some. So sometimes I let myself have it now. It's kind of nice. My pen cases or acrylic cases. I got these both from TJ Maxx or Marshalls. I bought different times. Acrylic stuff is so expensive and I don't like that it cracks or like gets scuffed so easily. You can buy this kind of stuff online, but it is so expensive. So I think each one of these was like 17 or 19 bucks, which was considerably less than what you can spend online. But I keep a bunch of pens and highlighters and stuff in here. A lot of these pens are from the Simply Gilded, subscription. I subscribed to that for like 3 or 4 years, before she changed it. Now you still get washi tape, but she used to do this huge subscription where you would get, I mean, honestly, way more stuff than the value that you were paying for, like, which is probably why she had to stop doing it. But it was incredible. And I loved every month of it. And then these little squishies are from Target. This little guy is from Daiso from a few years back. My husband got me, I think it was like a little box from Target, little Animal Crossing box, and that came in it. This squishy is actually from Walmart. I think this was actually 10 bucks, but this is one of the nicest squishies. Like, I normally wouldn't pay that much for it, but it's like so soft and squishy. It's like top tier squishy, so I'm okay with that. And this little bear is from Simply Gilded too. Put you back up there. More acrylic shelves, my main planner that I created. And then, yeah, this is my little work area. I love strawberries and I love birds and bird watching and birding. So last year for my birthday, my mom got me this little guy. She gives me the most thoughtful gifts. And this, I can't remember where I got this guy. He reminds me though, we used to have this cat growing up named Skittles. He was super, super fat and chubby and amazing. And, I also gave him a Russian name. I called him Gustavian. Don't ask me why, I just did. And anyway, he's no longer with us. We had him like a long time ago. But this little guy, it's like him in spirit. That's like exactly what his little attitude was like with his little belly. And then my microphone for podcasting. This used to be a lot more like bright pink, but it's just kind of faded. And one of my keyboards, a Bluetooth one. And I have another one back there. And I have my drink. See, I need to get my coasters. Oh my god. And that's why I had this little mat. But my podcast thing, I got some stickers printed out and then I found this little frame, and it has like glitter, and so I like that a lot. A little fidget toy. This thing's amazing. I have a Google Home. I honestly don't use it. I don't ever use it, so I might sell it. I don't know. This I got from Target. I have an iPad I use for digital planning and sometimes watching movies or shows in bed. And then I also have, oh, Bella totally left. She's probably taking a nap. More squish here. This tower has like pens. I have some, this is like branded business stuff. So I have business cards and I have, cards that I send to students. They enroll. This is a package from Temu. I have to unbox it. It's like stickers and stationery. And then down here, these are where I keep my other giant squishmallows. So there's Big Boy Ronnie and then these two, and they're my favorite. And honestly, I just love, like, I don't know, just the sensory feel of them at my desk. It's just nice to have them down there. So that's my office. I hope you enjoyed the little tour. Maybe I'll do another tour where I go like more in depth into some of the other stuff, but a lot of stuff I own is in our garage, and I'm in the process of still decluttering a lot of things, so I would actually like for there to be a lot fewer things in here, but for now, I'm happy with it, and it makes me very happy, and thanks for watching. Bye!